Hello my dear students, welcome to the next lecture in analog electronics. In this lecture we are going to discuss the FET application as a switch and voltage controlled resistance. So how can the FET operate as a switch? It can be used as a switch by operating in the two regions. Which are the two regions? The saturation region and the cutoff region. The cutoff region, in the sense when VGS is greater than VP, it goes to cutoff region. So when the VGS is 0, the FET operates in the saturation region, as we have seen here. When VGS is equal to 0, this is the saturation region with maximum drain current. And hence it is like a fully switched on condition. Okay. When the VGS applied is more negative than the pinch off voltage, the FET operates in its cutoff region. And it will not allow any current to flow from the drain to source. So the FET is in the fully off condition. So there are two methods in which you can use the FET as a switch, in shunt and series. When it is used as a shunt switch, you can see here the FET is connected in parallel to this. Okay, so it is connected in parallel to the load, and the input is given through this from this point, and the output is taken across this. So when VGS is 0 volt, when the switch is the applied voltage VGS is 0, the FET is turned on by operating in the saturation region. So the resistance is very small and is close to 100 ohm, or the output is 0. Okay. And the output voltage across the FET will be V out is equal to V in into RDS on by RD plus RDS on. So this resistance RD is very large, so that is why we are considering this output voltage to be 0. Okay, so this RDS on is very low, and this RD is very large compared to it. Okay, so actually this approximation is, it is 0 or close to 0, or the output you obtain, this is acting as a so this switch, this operation of this FET is causing the output to be 0. But what happens when you apply a negative voltage which is equal to the pinch off voltage? In that case the FET is operating in the cutoff region. So when this switch is closed, you are applying the negative voltage to this terminal, and it is greater than the pinch off value, then this is going to cutoff. Okay, under that condition this input will appear at the output. So this is offering very high resistance. Okay, this set is giving a very high resistance, or the input is directly obtained at the output. Okay. Now when it is used as a series switch, what is the condition? So the FET is connected in series with the input and output. That is, here you have the FET. Okay, and the control voltage is applied from this point. So when the control voltage is applied, you can see that it acts as a closed switch if the control voltage is 0, and open switch when the control voltage is negative and greater than the pinch off voltage. So when the control voltage is 0, this is in the on condition. Okay, and the input is obtained as output. When the control voltage is less than, more negative than the pinch off voltage, what happens? This goes to cutoff, or the input is not obtained at the output. That is what is written here. When the FET is on, the input signal will appear at the output, and when it is off, the output is 0. Now let us see the application of FET as a voltage controlled resistance. So you have we have already discussed the resistance of the ohmic region of the characteristics of FET. With that information we can start the discussion. The isolation that exists between the gate and drain circuits and the linear region of the JFET characteristics permit the approximation of the device by a resistive element between the drain and source terminals. Now the JFET is considered as a variable resistance whose resistance is controlled by the applied DC voltage at the gate terminal. It is controlled by VGS. I hope you remember this characteristics. This is the linear region or the ohmic region. It is marked here up to about VDS equal to this volt. In this region you have the linear region. Okay. Now as VGS is increased, you can see the resistance is varying here, isn't it? Now when VGS is equal to 0 volt, the resistance was 100 ohm if you calculate from this particular plot. this region. And as VGS is increased or VGS is becoming more and more negative, the resistance value is increasing in the linear region. Okay, so that is calculated for different points from the graph. So the resistance as VGS is reaching minus 2.5 volt, the RDS has increased to 3.3 kilo ohm from this 100 ohm. Or the drain to source resistance is increasing as the gate to source voltage approaches the pinch off value. So if you expand the linear region, you will get a plot like this. See, this is for VDS equal to 0.5 volt. Up to 0.5 volt, it is said to be the linear region. So I had marked this point here. So this region is expanded here in this figure. And the calculated values are marked here. VGS is equal to 0 volt, it is 100 ohm. And for minus 0.5, it is 160. It is keeping on increasing. And as it reaches minus 2.5 volt, it is 3.3 kilo ohm. So this FET can be used as a voltage controlled resistor because you are controlling the VGS to control the resistance of the device. And it finds many applications in analog circuits. You can go through the examples given in Boylestad where it is used in non-inverting amplifier circuits using op-amps as a variable resistor. Now there is an equation which provides a good approximation to the resistance level in terms of applied voltage VGS. If you know the pinch off voltage and VGS, and if you know R0, what is R0? It is the resistance with VGS is equal to 0 volt. Okay? If you know these values, you can find out RD at different levels of VGS. Okay? So if you calculate using this equation, the values will be slightly different from what you obtained from the graph. It will be slightly different, but still it is a good approximation. If you know these values, R0, VP, and you can compute using this approximate equation for different values of VGS, you can find out the value of RD. Okay, so with this, I am ending this discussion on the application of FET as a switch and variable resistance. Thank you.